Hello everyone, welcome to the MacTech channel. Today's topic of discussion is the SMAW. It means it is the type of welding or it is a welding process, and it is also called as MMAW welding. That is manual metal arc welding, and SMAW means shielded metal arc welding. So this is the welding process. As you know, welding processes are material joining techniques in which by heating the metal or material with the suitable temperature, with or without application of the pressure, or by the application of the pressure, that two metals will be joined together. Homogeneous joint will be made. It is also called as welding, and this process is called welding processes. And in this process, we can use a filler, external filler metal, or without filler metal, we can join the metals or materials. So today's topic of discussion is mainly shielded metal arc welding. This is the one type of metal means welding process that we'll discuss only, because the welding processes are very vast. So for today's discussion, I have taken one topic only, SMAW welding. So going further, we'll see the details about the shielded metal arc welding, which is also called as a manual metal arc welding. So in this figure, it is schematic representation of the shielded metal arc welding. You can see there is one electrode. It is also called as means arc electrode, and this electrode having the flux coating, and inside that flux there is a core wire. When you are doing the welding, then the arc is produced by this welding rod is holded in the welding holder, and it is connected to the power source or welding machines, and that the welding rod, it is generally called as welding rod, that means ignite, or you can say with the application of current, there weld metal pool, or it melts the welding means material, and it also on its own it melts and make a weld pool, and on that you can start progressing. Means arc is established between flux coated electrode and the base metal, and from in that process gases evolved by burning of flux which is coated on the core wire. That is also important to shield the arc, because that arc should not come into contact with the atmosphere or environmental conditions, because if it contacts, means if there is no flux around that arc, then atmosphere gases will contaminate in that weld metal pool or inside that arc, and the weld will not be sound, and there are many weld defects inside that. So flux is very important, and that is coated on that means if you see the welding electrode, and there is one solid wire, core wire, on that the flux coating is there. So flux is very important. This when that weld pool is established, then weld metal is covered by the slag, and that we can easily remove, because when once welding is done, that slag we can remove by chipping or any other cleaning or grinding process. We can remove that slags. So this is the oldest method of welding. These are means very old method, very simple method. Anybody can learn this welding he can do the this one welding. So this is very important. We will see what are the advantages of this welding process and what are the limitations of this process in this slide. So advantages is that is this is versatile process. We can do welding in all positions, means we can do welding in flat position, horizontal position, vertical positions, overhead positions. In all positions we can do welding. And then when there is a restricted access for any joint or any area where means you cannot do welding with the other processes, so with this process you can easily do the welding for that particular small area where the area is restricted. We can weld wide variety of the materials with this process, but for material thickness above 3 mm, means below that, what will happen? That material will burn and it will not be joined. So it requires a material thickness above 3 mm. And the equipment is very simple and light. We can carry the equipment anywhere you want. We can means nowadays the equipments are compact size. We can carry by hand also for the small weldings. So this is the advantages of this welding process SMAW. We'll see what are the limitation in that. So first limitation is the low productivity. Why low productivity? Because we are using welding electrode, which is having a size means length of 250 mm, 350 mm, 450 mm, like that only. Means when we have to do the welding of 1 meter or any more than that, then we have to change the electrode every time. So means the changing time, and again you have to do the arc strike, again you have to do the grinding for the start and end points. That is the time consumption, and so, and there is a manual operation, because manually you have to do the all these processes, because you have to means you have to take a rod from the box and then put it in the holder and then start welding. After the 300 mm, it will consume one rod. Then again you have to take out the other electrode, then you have to put it in the electrode holder. Like that you have to go on changing the rods, so the productivity will be very less. If you have to do more welding or more length welding, then this welding is not suitable, because the productivity will be low. In this case, the automation, the second limitation I am talking, this in this case the automation is not possible, because manually we are being, because we have to take out, like as I have explained, what is the process in this. So automation is not possible in this process. So that is the one limitation. Then it also depends on the welder skill, because the arc length he has to maintain. If there is change in the arc length, then there is chances of weld defects. So welder skill is also important. This welding process is not suitable for welding of exotic high quality materials. So this is one limitation of the SMAW welding. So further we discuss about the what is the process of this shielded metal arc welding. So as I explained, in this process, coalescence of metal is produced by heat from an electric arc that is maintained between the tip of coated electrode and the surface of a base metal in joint being welded. Then arc shielding is obtained from the gases that form as a result of decomposition of certain ingredients of electrode coating. The shielding employed along with the core wire largely controls the mechanical properties, chemical composition, and metallurgical structure of the weld metal. So, main functions of electrode coatings are: it provides gas to shield the arc. It provides deoxidizers and fluxing agents that prevent excessive grain growth. It establishes the electrical characteristics of the electrode. It provides a slag blanket to protect the hot weld metal from the air. It increases the ionization potential. This is the electrode coatings functions. Besides these functions, sometimes some alloying elements are also present in the electrode coating to change the mechanical properties of the weld metal. We can discuss types of flux electrode. So, arc stability, depth of penetration, metal deposition rate, and positional capability are greatly influenced by the chemical composition of flux coating on the electrodes. These electrodes can be divided into three main groups. First is the cellulosic, rutile, and basic. So, cellulosic electrodes are which contains a high proportion of cellulose in the coating and are characterized by a deeply penetrating arc and a rapid burn-off rate, giving high welding speeds. Weld deposit can be coarse and with fluid slag. Deslagging can be difficult. These electrodes are easy to use in any position and are noted for their use in the stovepipe welding technique. The features of these electrodes are deep penetration in all positions means we can achieve full penetration in all positions. Suitability for vertical down welding, reasonably good mechanical properties, high level of hydrogen generated, risk of cracking in the heat affected zone, HHF. So in this case, what happens? There is chances of hydrogen contamination in the weld pool, and the delayed cracking, we can say that is hydrogen cracking in the heat effect zone will be there. Then second type is the rutile electrodes. Rutile electrodes contain a high proportion of titanium oxide in the coating. Titanium oxide promotes easy arc ignition, smooth arc operation, and low spatters. These electrodes are general purpose electrode with good welding properties. They can be used with AC and DC power sources, and in all positions we can do the welding. These electrodes are especially suitable for welding fillet joints in the horizontal vertical positions. The features of rutile electrodes are moderate weld metal mechanical properties, good bed profile produced through the viscous slag, positional welding possible with fluid slag containing fluoride, easily removable slag. We can easily remove the slag. Then third type is the basic electrodes. Basic electrodes contain a high proportion of calcium carbonate, that is the limestone, and calcium fluoride, fluorspar, in the coating. This makes their slag coating more fluid than rutile coatings. This is also fast freezing, which assists welding in the vertical and overhead positions. These electrodes are used for welding medium and heavy section fabrications where higher weld quality, good mechanical properties, and resistance to cracking due to high restraints are required. The process scope of SMAW is: the shielded metal arc welding is used in joining and surfacing application on variety of base metal. The suitability of process for any specific base metal depends on the availability of the covered electrode whose weld metal has the required composition and properties. Electrodes are available for the following base metals, means for carbon steel we can use the electrodes of SMAW, low alloy steels, corrosion resistance, stainless steels, cast irons, aluminum and aluminum alloys, copper and copper alloys, nickel and nickel alloys, cobalt and cobalt alloys. For these base metals, we have available the welding electrodes. So we can use electrodes for these base metals as it is easily available. The shielded metal arc welding is adaptable to any material thickness, means below above 3 mm, within certain practicable and economical limitations. For material thickness less than 2 mm, the base metal will melt through and molten metal will fall away before weld can be established. Because of limited deposition rate, it is economical, not to advisable, to go beyond 38 mm. Most of the shielded metal arc welding application is on thickness between 3 to 38 mm, means the range of the shielded metal arc best is the 3 mm to 38 mm. This is the best range of thickness we can weld with the SMAW welding. Then classification of SMAW welding electrodes according to AWS. AWS arc welding electrodes for different material. A numbering system has been devised for electrode of different material. AWS A5.1-81, these are the specifications for carbon steel covered arc welding electrodes. This coding system starts with the prefix E. You can see the electrode starts with the E7018, E6013, like that it starts for the carbon steel electrodes. So with in that prefix E is the designate, it is designated as electrode. The next two digits number is 60 or 70. The number 60 indicates the tensile strength of 60 KSI or 60,000 PSI of the weld deposit. Similarly, 70 means minimum weld metal team tensile strength of 70 KSI. Then the third digit indicates the position in which the electrodes can be used satisfactorily. The last two digits, third and fourth taken together, indicates current condition, type of current and type of coating. Following table, means beside this table, shows the complete classification as also significance of the last two digits. Means you can see the AWS classification as E6010, E6013, E6020, 7018, like that. And their metal strength I have given according to first two digits is the 60 KSI. Then the type of covering welding positions are high, means for this it is mentioned in the third column, and type of current which we can use this I have mentioned in the last column. Okay, this is the table we can refer further. Then next for AWS classification, the AWS A5.5-81, it is for low alloy steel covered arc welding electrode. This classification system is the same as for carbon steel electrode, that is the prefix E designates the electrode. The first two digits or the 3 or 5 digit number designate the minimum tensile strength of the welding KSI. The third digit or the fourth digit or 5 digit number indicates the welding position. The last two digits taken together indicates the current condition as well as the coating type, exactly as the carbon steel electrode classification. In addition, letter suffix such as A1, B1, C2 is there, and it designates the chemistry of deposited metal. The next AWS 5.4-81, this specification for corrosion resistant, resisting chromium and chromium nickel steel covered electrodes. This is very exhaustive standard covering 38 classes with chromium in the weld deposit ranging from 4 to 32% and nickel from 0 to 37%. In this standard, the electrodes are classified on the basis of the chemistry and mechanical property requirements of the weld metal. The classification system consists of suffix letter E to indicate an electrode, followed by various combination of digit and letters to indicate the chemical composition of weld metal, which is further followed by 15 or minus 16 to indicate position of welding and type of current. In stainless steel electrode, the cover, core, wire chemistry and weld metal chemistry need not necessarily be identical. For example, an E308 moly electrode or an E310 electrode may have 304 SS type core wire and flux covering alloyed with requisite proportion of chromium, nickel and moly if necessary. Hence, it would be incorrect to verify an electrode class by analyzing its core wire. One must get an undiluted all weld metal and determine its core wire chemistry. In designation 15 and 16, one indicates that the electrode in size 4 mm lower can be used in all positions. The last digit 5 means that the electrode works only on DC positive, and 6 means the electrode works either on AC or DC, both it can work. A few classes carry suffix L, which indicates that carbon content in the deposits is restricted to 0.04% maximum. In order to obtain resistance to intergranular corrosion caused by carbide precipitation, which can occur when the carbon content is higher and welded joint is exposed to corrosive media in service, where suffix H indicates high carbon content. These are meant for the welding of high alloy heat and corrosion resistant casting of same general composition. The power sources for SMW weldings are electrodes can be operated with the AC and DC power supply. Not all DC electrodes can be operated on AC power sources. However, AC electrodes are normally used on the DC. So this is very versatile process, SMW welding. This have many advantages as I have discussed. So, and the equipments are readily available. Welding machines we can carry nowadays. It's very compact machines are also available. One limitation, as I said, we cannot do automations, but there are chances that we can do automation by increasing the rod length and automatic means feeding of the rods in the joint, in the means in the holder of the welding rod, that rod holder we have to modify that rod holder, and we have to fix means some automation we have to do for the holding rod holding, so it can maintain the arc as required. And we can means it has to change the electrodes after consumption, and the movement of the rod means electrode holder is we have to automate it. But it's very difficult process, and still there is no automation in this process. And SMW welding is very means not done generally on the root runs. It is done on the after that root runs on the pipe joints, and it's very popular welding. And for general practices, this SMW everywhere you can. For structural welding, this is mainly used because structures are having the means it has some restricted areas where you have to carry out the welding. So this SMW welding is very popular in structural weldings. So further we can discuss on many welding processes are there. There are many MIG-MAG welding process, then GTAW welding processes there, electrosag welding process, robotic welding is there. These are very welding processes we can discuss further. So today we'll stop here. Thank you from my side. If you have any queries, you can ask, or if you have liked my videos, you can just like, share and subscribe my channel. I upload many videos related to the other topics related to our mechanical background. So thank you. Stay safe, stay home. Thank you all.